Hey gang, welcome to the Cross-Eyed Texan. It's time for the midweek shave. This is going to be shave number 8 as I journey through all the soaps I have on the doorway behind me. And I have some in this cabinet up here, but I'm going to do a series where I just shave once with each one of the soaps that I have, with maybe some special shaves in between if I'm, you know, testing out a new piece of hardware or something. And I may actually get a new, a razor soon. But I'm about to use my Pure Badger brush that I got from Walmart. No, not Walmart. The Walmart of the internet, Amazon. And I just wanted to show you guys what kind of box it actually comes in. It has a very nice presentation, honestly, for something that's this inexpensive. That looks pretty snazzy. I like it. But I want to give my, I'm going to give my Omega brush a break. Mostly because I didn't clean it out. I forgot. That's the problem with shaving on Sunday morning. So we're going to put this in the old Texas mug right here. And we are doing a cold water shave today because it's just hot. And the soap that I'm using actually facilitates cold water very well. And as you saw it from the thumbnail, it is going to be Boardwalk Barbershop. I absolutely love this stuff. And I've got the matching aftershave. And we are going to be using a Nisette blade in this razor. This is honestly probably the fourth or fifth time I've used this razor. The third time I used it was when I did just a video a few weeks ago with this having a feather blade in it, and it just improved it dramatically. I mean, I always knew that it would make a difference if I used a better blade in it. I just never got around to trying it. But we're gonna put this blade in here and we're gonna get on with it. I like Nisettes just as much as I like feathers. These are, in my humble opinion, kind of an underrated blade. I hope everybody's doing well. I think we're having a cold front come in because it's only going to be about 98 degrees instead of 100, so every little bit helps. I really like the finishing on this, and I like how it has a VB in there. I try to keep this razor very clean. And there's no wiggle on that bar right there. It stays pretty straight. Viking blade catches a lot of garbage. And if you don't like them, that's fine. Also, I'm going to be drinking some Community Coffee Dark and Bold. I'll put a link if you're interested. I'm going to put one even if you're not interested for the coffee I'm drinking. This is good stuff. I got it from Amazon. And it was like $8. And it's a good dark roast coffee. My shave prep today is just going to be wetting my face. Normally, I do my shave videos after I've taken a shower. But I have to be at recovery tonight. And since it's so hot, I try to take my shower about an hour and 10 minutes before I have to leave, so I don't get funky while I'm gone. So I'm going to, I got my trusty wash rag here. And I am just going to kind of scrub a little bit. Had part of it in the water. And I like to scrub my face a little bit. Not just wet it. And I'm sure that's screwing with a microphone, and I'll hear that on the replay. There we go. We are going to... I love the way this stuff smells. We are going to face lather. And I'm only going to squeeze the bottom of that brush. Not all the way to the top, just the bottom. That way, as I'm lathering up the soap, should get some more water coming down from the base. And let's see if this Viking's Blade Chieftain Odin will perform equally well with a Nisette in it. Now, I would not use this razor if I had excessive beard growth. That just wouldn't happen. I don't think that's what that thing's best for. That should be enough. But if not, I know where it is. All right, let's get the shave on. I want a little more water. Oh, did I mention but that far away from being monetized? The channel has been accepted into the YouTube partnership program, and I wanted to thank all you guys for it. I originally just started this channel to have something to do. I'm not expecting to be a millionaire, but if I can make enough money to where I can use the money I get from the channel to help me buy fragrances and shaving gear, and the occasional watch, I can just pour that back into the channel and have a hobby that pays for itself. I've never had a hobby that paid for itself. And it gives me a chance to give some much needed encouragement to somebody who may need it. There's a lot of men out there that really need some encouragement, you know. And that's really where my heart is, at the Cross-Eyed Texan. All right, let's see how this bad boy goes, and I'm gonna be quiet while I'm actually shaving. As you can tell, there's not a whole lot of blade exposure on that. And there's not a lot of gap either. You know, I can already tell this did a pretty good job. This razor is actually going to wind up in my rotation when my beard's not overgrown, because I don't know about y'all, sometimes I get lazy and I don't shave, even though I enjoy it. Incredible. Not bad at all. All right, so I'm going to wet this brush again a little bit. And we're going to go back in, and I want about an equal amount of soap as I had the first time. I don't personally think it's a good idea to use less on the second pass, especially if you're going against the grain, because that's where the irritation can kick in. So I want to lather this up very well. That should be enough. All right. I always have to dry my hands off with Phoenix Artisan soap because it is slick as it can be. Here we go. This soap performs great in hot water or cold water. Smells good, tastes terrible. And it's certainly some cream you do not want in your coffee. All right, here we go. I do notice this thing clogs up a little bit. All right, let's dry my face off and see what we're dealing with here. It's not as good as it was with the feather, that's for sure. But this razor is even more gentle than an Edwin Jagger DE89. But it did an okay job, and I just mean okay. See, I'm having to go back a third time And if your razor is too mild and you're having to go back over things, then it just, it's not good. Yeah, that's not good. All right, I'm about to do something I don't normally do. Give me just 1 second here. I guess it works okay with feathers in it, but I don't have any problems with the build quality of it. It's built well, but that is either going to go back under the cabinet or something like that, but it's not going to be used again. I don't like it, not because it's made in China. I don't like it, not because it's poor quality, because it doesn't seem that way to me. I don't like it because it couldn't cut a fart. Hear that blade cutting through all that? Live and frustrated from the bathroom. Yeah, I'm not using that razor anymore. I don't recommend it. Unless you just want to use it with a feather blade. But it is going back in the box. It may wind up in the trash. Because I would have a hard time giving it to somebody. Knowing how I feel about it. I don't give bad products to people. I don't think that's right. All right, so now we finally got my face done and I can feel the irritation from it. Because I had to go back over it so many times. Remember, there's such a thing as too mild and there's such a thing as too aggressive. And sometimes you got to work around and find out what works best for you. This is my favorite razor, bar none. It's my game changer, and it's the one I use the most. And it's really the reason I haven't bought another razor. Although there is one I'd like to get. And I really wanted to use, God almighty. And I really wanted to use, you know what? I'm gonna man up and use the aftershave, even though it's gonna burn. Yeah, I try to leave my videos just as real and raw. As I possibly can, because I would have done that off camera. I didn't do that for anybody's amusement. I did it because the razor was hacking me off. Razor hack. See what I did there? Anyway, That does it for this shave, and that is the last time you're going to see that razor on any video that I make. But regardless, I wanted to thank you guys for helping me get accepted to the YPP YouTube Partnership Program, because I couldn't have done it without you. I appreciate all the great support I get. When you're visually impaired and you stick yourself out there, you expose yourself to ridicule, and I haven't gotten any of it. And I appreciate you guys. Anyway, thank you for watching. Give me a thumbs up on the video if you liked it. Subscribe to the channel. I'm going to do, at the request of a subscriber, a review on my favorite powdery fragrances from my collection. I didn't think I had any, but it turned out, and I only thought I had a couple, but I got 7 of them. So we're going to talk about that. I may do that today. Anyway, God bless you guys. Don't just take care of yourself. Take care of somebody else. God bless you guys.